Hi folks, welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I've put together this oak entrance frame and glazed door. So stick around and I'll show you how I got on. So the entry glazed vestibule is pretty much there now. I've gone ahead with my window guy down the road and ordered some units that will go in here. They're going to be toughened, double glazed, standard argon fill units. So it's beginning to look quite promising and somewhere close to what I was hoping for. We've got all of the hinges cut now. I'll give you a close up in a minute. I can just about slide one in there to give it a look. I wasn't sure to go for brass or for stainless steel. I've gone for stainless steel in the end. The brass hinges I had are lovely, nice, classic looking hinges, but the spacing on them just, it left quite a big gap either side. Anyway, that was part of the detailing, which I won't confuse you with. But we've now got what is basically three different timbers, and this is my attempt to kind of tie them in together. Now, when I say three different timbers, it's not strictly true. We've got this frame, which is sold as oak, but it's not. It's a Malaysian or Asian timber. It's very similar in grain structure. Some companies just sell it as oak. Some say it's oak look or oak effect, but basically it's certainly not your typical oak, but it's close enough. And if I give you a little close up now here, you'll see what I mean. If there's any discrepancy between whatever door you're fitting and this, you can just tint it a little bit to stain it a little bit darker, and it's easier to tie stuff in. The door is one of that batch that I bought on a clearance deal last year. It's a veneered solid core door. It's external, double glazed. Yes, you could do the whole thing in solid oak, but really I've got no problems going with the veneer, especially because we've got that nice big overhang and it's quite a protected area. And then our third piece of the jigsaw is the capping boards. So these are the boards, the capping boards or the face boards on the outside. And I'll go into much more detail when we actually come to fit the frame in the next episode. But essentially these will cap over all of the exposed posts and beams of the green oak. And that's the way we're going to secure this in place. So it'll be covering about that much. This frame did come as a kit, but it needs quite a lot of fabrication to make it fit the opening. That's kind of the idea with it. There were tenons on the mullions and on these jambs, but they really needed to be taken off. Well, they didn't need to be. I could have cut mortises, but I'm lazy. And they were only on one end, so we would have ended up screwing the bottom anyway. All the top, and but they were nicely contoured already to fit around these, and then I had to mirror that with the other end to make sure that everything was pitched to help any water runoff, make sure nothing was trapped underneath. Same with these bits of blocking down here. These frames are usually you buy the side fixed lights, basically just come like mini doors with a frame and you sit them in. But if you want to direct glaze it like I am, where I'm going to use the double glaze unit in here, you get an extra set of timber, which is these blocks, which kind of give you an upstand at the bottom and some more beading, and we'll externally glaze these, but we'll get into that in the future video. But they needed quite a lot of chopping around as well to get to fit nice. And before anyone says it, yes, I could have bought a whole stack of joinery grade timber and made all of my own frames and milled it all down, but you know, I've only got so much time. And I probably would have done a lot worse of a job than this factory produced stuff. And it's in, it's done, and it's still taken quite a bit of joinery to get to fit. So I don't feel like I've cheated too much. But anyway, that's it. I can't wait to get these fitted, just waiting for a dry day. And then we can get it all slotted in. Hopefully everything goes to plan. But thank you for watching. Remember, if you can, do it yourself. We'll see you next time.